A marketing strategy is your overall plan for how to reach potential customers and interest them in your products and services. Your marketing strategy will contain information about the company's or your brand's value proposition. It will contain information and data about your target customers, the key messages that you want to give, and other important data. It is the basis for forming your marketing plans. Academics argue extensively about the precise definition of what a marketing strategy is. But we're going to be a lot more pragmatic, and rather than argue about the definition, let's understand the sort of things that need to go into it. And it has to start with a statement of your company's or your brand's value proposition, what it is you are offering to the market. This will allow you to tell your customers why you deserve their custom. And it will also give your marketing teams a framework within which to create their marketing plans for the individual marketing initiatives across your portfolio of products and services. So, your marketing strategy will inform your marketing plans. It is a long-term document that sits alongside your wider organizational strategy. Within the span of a single marketing strategy, you might have several annual cycles of marketing plans. But that's not to say you shouldn't be keeping your marketing strategy under constant review. During the duration of its life, it might go through a number of cycles of refresh. A marketing plan, on the other hand, is a document that details specific activities and schedules and budgets for individual marketing initiatives. So, in summary, marketing strategies cover the big picture, whilst your marketing plans are tactical documents that cover individual campaigns. The purpose of your marketing strategy is to gain a long-term, sustainable competitive advantage over your competitors. And we do this by grabbing the attention of potential customers and building their commitment and ultimately loyalty towards your brand and your products. Your marketing strategy will, of course, embrace the total marketing mix, the four P's of product, price, place, and promotion. There are five broad elements to a marketing strategy. The first element is a strategic analysis. Here, you look at things like your market and the demographics of your customer base. You'll look at your competitors and their products, services, and messages to the market. And of course, you will look at the opportunities and the threats facing your business. Secondly, your marketing strategy needs to articulate your marketing goals, what it is you want to achieve over the duration of the strategy. This could represent things like market awareness, market share, consumer behaviours, consumer perceptions, and indeed public relations. Third, it needs to tie into your competitive strategy. You need to understand what that strategy is so that you can create the right marketing messages to support it. The four key competitive strategies are first, cost leadership or price leadership, aiming to be a low-cost player in the market that people come to because they expect good value for money. The second thing is product or service differentiation, offering a product or service that is noticeably different from those of your competitors, usually by quality, but sometimes by functionality. Third is a niche focus, offering products and services that no one else quite offers, building a reputation through your marketing strategy as being an expert in a narrow but clearly defined niche. And fourth, your fourth strategy is one of brand loyalty, building up a following who will unquestioningly purchase your products or services. Initially, this may be keyed off through differentiation or niche focus, possibly, but less commonly, through price advantage. But ultimately, your strategy is all about building a cadre of loyal fans, customers who want your products, want your services, because of the associations they have for your brand. This is brand marketing taken to the ultimate. Having done this, the fourth part of your marketing strategy is to articulate the key messages that you want to get out to the market. These are going to be all about the value proposition of your brand or of your products and services. So what are the aspects that you want to promote and how will you promote them? Finally, in your marketing strategy, you need to define your approach to the market. How are you going to conduct your marketing campaigns? It's possible to combine a number of approaches, but there are five core approaches that you can take. Approach number one is to take on your competitors directly. Go against them head to head, feature for feature, benefit for benefit. Aim to beat them by producing superior marketing, superior advertising, clearer messages. Take your equivalent products and make them seem to your market the superior product. This is only really possible when your product has a feature set that is superior to the equivalent feature set of your competitors. It's almost impossible to craft a marketing campaign that goes head to head with competitors that can beat you on every element of its feature set. It's okay to have one aspect of the feature set subordinate to those of your competitors, but if all of them are subordinate, then fundamentally arguing that your product or service is better is deceptive. The second approach is to take on your competitor absolutely and completely. If you believe that your product is superior in every way, then go all out to make the case. Good quality marketing is not about trashing the opposition. It's about building up the case for your product, your services, your brand. But if you fundamentally believe that you do have a completely superior brand every way, this may be your strategy to try to crush your competitor and leave them scrabbling for a niche in which they can hold on to some element of their market share. The third approach is usually only suitable when you know your product or your service is not a market leader. And this is to identify features where your competitors are weak and promote your product on those features only. This is slightly different to arguing that your product is better than competitors on the market. It's actually identifying for each competitor one or two features against which you can compete effectively. The fourth approach is to select your competition carefully. Rather than taking on your main competitors, find small competitors that you can outcompete more easily and use your marketing to win market share from them and therefore grow your overall market share to become a bigger player against your main competitors. And the fifth approach is what we might call guerrilla marketing, using innovative marketing techniques to change the nature of the conversation about your products, your services, or your brand. This is arguably the most creative form of marketing, and it is designed to transform the market's perceptions of your products and of the market in general. And if you can do this, you can define a new battleground for the marketing campaigns to come. Your marketing strategy will say very little, if anything, about how to go about putting forward the messages to the market. It's all about determining what the shape of those messages are and the overall strategy. From this, you can develop your marketing plan and craft the campaigns you need. Please do give us a like if you've learned from this video. I'll be creating loads more great management courses content for you, so please do subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of that valuable content. I look forward to seeing you in the next one, and in the meantime, keep learning.